Hello guys, welcome to another Path of Exile guide. This guide is about this moment when you wake up on the beach with level 1. You are scared and weak. And the guide will end when you are strong enough to finish the storyline and kill Kitava. This guide is a PoE leveling guide which I made mainly for Path of Exile beginners. So I guess more experienced players will not hear so much news in this video. First I want to give you a few general informations before we start. Then I make a short crash tutorial about Path of Building, in my opinion the most important tool for Path of Exile. It really helps to make the right decisions and don't waste too much currency. If you are not interested in Path of Building, just skip this chapter. After that I will have 4 chapters about leveling, in which I will recommend some gear and skill gems and explain a few things on the way. In my opinion, the most important thing while leveling is don't rush it. If you feel too weak, just grind some levels and gear in some safe area. I will show a few good grinding areas a bit later. For leveling, I recommend to use 2 life flask, 1 mana flask and 2 quicksilver flask for fast movement speed. Normally, the self-found raw gear you will find while leveling should be perfectly fine. On raw gear, look mainly for life, resistances, damage to attacks and attack speed. Now I want to show you where you can find the good grinding places I talked before. In Act 4 you have the Dried Lake and the Aqueduct. Please keep in mind, your own level should always be near the monster level to avoid experience penalties. In Act 5 I would recommend the Chambers of Innocence if you need to get a bit stronger before progressing. The next good area to grind you will find in the Act 9, the Blood Aqueduct. Maybe one of the best areas to grind a few levels and gear. The reason is the perfect map layout and also that in this area the humility cards can drop. 9 of those cards can be traded for a double Arasa. In Act 10 you find another good spot, Desecrated Chambers. When you use String and right click on the area you can make a new instance. Some of you may ask yourself, what the fuck is Path of Building? It is a program to simulate different Path of Exile builds. It can help you to make the right decisions and save you a lot of currency. But more importantly, it will definitely help to make you stronger, faster, and this will result in more fun for you. The first step is to import your character into Path of Building. Click on Import, Export Build. Choose the character you want to import and import the passive tree, gems, items and skills. Now you see it has imported your character into Path of Building. So for example, if you are not sure which bow you would buy, which will increase your DPS most, you can go to the Path of Exile gamepedia.com homepage and check out all unique bows. If you have a few items you want to test, you can just add it to your gear in Path of Building and you will see how your stats will change when you use this instead of your current gear. In this example I decided to compare the bows Doomfledged Prison and the Tempest, with the result that for my current setup the Doomfledged Prison gives way more DPS, nearly doubles my DPS to my old bow. You also can improve your skill tree with this program by using the option Show Node Power, which will show you in red the best nodes for your DPS and in blue the best nodes for your defense. Please be aware that it is always for the selected main skill. That makes it easy to improve your skill tree and plan your next steps. Now I also want to show you how you can find the best skill gem setups for your builds. If you want to test if there are better options to your current setup, just deactivate the support gems you are not sure about and then click in the field to add a gem. It will automatically show the supported gems which will provide the highest DPS for the selected main skill. In the video example you see that I can improve my DPS when I change a few support skills. Please be aware that you need to make a realistic configuration because otherwise the shown DPS will just be bullshit. Now I want to show you the most important leveling units and skill gems, which become available between level 1 and 10. As a ranger, you will start with Burning Arrow and will receive Split Arrow and Pierce very soon, which should be linked together. Burning Arrow is good for single target, and Split Arrow linked with Pierce gives you a good clear speed early on. Tabula Rasa is the leveling item, because it gives you a 6 link item from level 1. Other good leveling units are Wanderlust Boots and the Black Cat Ring. With level 4 you will get a Decoy Totem, which is great to have a distraction for the enemies. Mirage Archer should be linked with your damage setups. The next big step is level 8, when the added damage support gems become available, which are very good for leveling. These support gems will be the best option for a while and should be linked with your damage skills. With level 10, Clarity will become available, which helps a lot to sustain mana, and with Blink Arrow we get our movement skill. Hero's Bite is crazy good for leveling, because it gives a lot of attributes, damage and survivability with life on hit. This item can be used all the way to level 70. Now just a bit gameplay to show you how the skills work and look. Please keep in mind that all skills and items are just recommendations, and there are a lot more viable options. Don't forget to always use your Quicksilver Flask to improve your speed while leveling. With level 12 we get Rain of Arrows, which are used as main skill up to level 70 and higher. You can drop Burning Arrow and Split Arrow, because the great thing about the reworked Rain of Arrows is that it's decent for clear speed and single target DPS. With level 16 the Heralds become available, and I recommend to use one or two of them together with Clarity. Faster attacks, elemental damage with attacks and concentrated effect becomes available with level 18. I would recommend to level them in your off gear slots, because later on you will need those gems for your main damage setups. Warlord's Mark, Purity of Elements are also gems you will need a bit later on. I use Purity of Elements often while leveling, because I don't want to waste too much time to get decent resistances with the gear while leveling. Asenath's Gentle Touch are just great clothes for leveling, which will help your survivability a lot. Here you see the end of Act 1 and an overview over the starting gear while leveling. Here in this gameplay you see how the Herald improves your DPS and clear speed. On Alira I show how effective Val Rain of Arrows is against single targets. The Doomfledged Bow is really good for leveling and really cheap. Normally it should be available for one alchemy ore. I would recommend to use an Ice Golem for a good DPS boost. Make a cast and damage taken setup as soon as possible, because it will save your life many times. Link cast and damage taken with Immortal Call and Warlord's Mark. Keep cast and damage taken at level 1 and only level Immortal Call and Warlord's Mark, so that the required level is not higher than 38. Here is another quick overview over the gear, stats and skills with level 25. Now you can see the skill tree are used while leveling, but I would recommend that you follow the skill tree of the build you want to play later on. Now following some gameplay, some boss kills at Dreso, you can see why the decoy totem is so nice to avoid damage. For the last push to level 70, I would recommend to upgrade your bow a last time. In my case, I would upgrade it from a Doomfledge to a Doomfledge Prism, which nearly doubled my DPS. Doomfledge Prism is not that cheap, but absolutely worth it when you can afford it. Also, you should constantly upgrade your gear with the items you find while leveling. Now following some uncommented gameplay of the level 39 to 70. Enjoy, guys!
it cannot be extinguished.
When you kill Kitava at the end of the storyline, you will receive a debuff which will reduce your resistances a lot. So my recommendation is to use your currency to gear up and cap all your resistances at 75. I hope you like this little bow leveling guide. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you soon and have fun, guys!